Hey guys, if you have clients for web building, you are leaving money on the table, just like I did for years. But I'm going to show you a way how to get the $300 recurring revenue per client per year by adding real value to their business. Because what is the nightmare of an online business owner? Getting hacked, corrupted files, backup gone wrong, losing conversions because of speed, or your design completely changed after an update. Oh, I hate that. Now you can take care of all these things completely automated and also sending client reports every single month that everything is okay. A premium service that your clients will gladly pay for that ease of mind. To do this all completely automated, we are going to need a tool. Or you can of course do it manually. Just log in early in the morning, all your 50 client websites, doing backups, make sure the design never changes after an update. Sure, why not? To get the tool to support me, but also to get 1 year for 5 clients completely free of charge, follow this link, go to wp.discount/wpremote. This link is also in the description of this video and of course in the comments section. To make use of the 1 year completely free of the basic plan, fill in your credit card information over here. Now, no worries, you won't get charged today, only after a year if you decide to continue with WP Remote. So we have an entire year to find out if you can sell this to your own clients. Let's do some quick math. If we have one client that pays us $25 each single month for this care plan, when you do that times 12, your cost of WP Remote is already covered. And then the first year is entirely free. So if we get 4 more clients, because in this plan we can fit 5 clients, do the math. That's a revenue of $1,200 recurring revenue every single year. That's a no-brainer. And then we just gotta upscale it to more people. But you get 1 year to try this out. When we have entered our credit card information, our payment was successfully processed. Then you can see that the next charge will only take place next year. So that gives us an entire year to find clients. After this, we click over here on sites and we're going to add in multiple sites to WP Remote. To do this, press on this plus icon and add in the URL and press over here on continue. Add in your admin username and password and they will install it for you, a painless process. Now don't worry, they never store your WP admin credentials. But if you're not okay with that, just download it and install it manually on all your websites you want to have it. I assume you know how to install plugins, because if not, why do you have even clients? If you've installed it manually, click over here on test plugin. There we go. Initiate sync. Great, now our website will be synced. Click over here on sites to add more websites. Your website will be added over here after the sync is completed. So click over here on add site to add in another one. On this page, you can select multiple websites like this. Select everyone you want and go and manage their plugins or manage their themes, the users, update WordPress or install the tag. If you have a lot of websites, those tags are very useful. Now let's go over here to dashboard. On the dashboard, you can see the overview of all your client websites. When you are seeing this video, it might be that this user interface had an update, so it might look a little bit different from your site. On the left side, we see over here the overview. You can see how many sites are connected and if they are disconnected from WP Remote. We can also see the amount of clients we have, the amount of websites we have, people in our team, and how much the auto update is. If someone is offline, you can see that also immediately. In the center, we can see all the updates from all our connected websites. On the right, we see the notifications of WP Remote itself. Now, this is the overview of all the different kind of features. If you want to see details per website, we go over here to sites, or we use the search engine. Just type in your website, there it is, click on it, and you will go immediately to the details of that specific site. In the overview of the sites, you can see all the modules that are enabled for this specific website. You can also just skip to the AccessWP admin, start a fresh sync, see the site's history, or more details about this site. If you click over here, It's just when you click on the main website. Now let me walk you through all these modules on WPremote. First we have backup. We click over here on backup. We can see we have one backup. In this plan, you have one backup per day. That's pretty nice, but there's also more what you can do with this backup. You can migrate it. If you click over here, you can select a destination, external or internal website, and you can quickly deploy an entire backup to maybe a subdomain. When you click over here, it will restore the latest backup. You can also upload your backup to Dropbox, download it on your physical computer, or over here, test a restore. Because we all remember those times where you wish you had checked the backup before you restored them, right? Down here we have real-time updates. It's not included in the basic plan, but what this is when you have a WooCommerce website, for example, every single order be placed, a new backup will be created right there. So you will never lose any client data at all. Let's get back. Then we can just click over here and add some notes. For example, like this, you can delete it, you can edit them or add more notes on this client. Very useful. And over here, you can enable security and firewall. If you check this box, we need to upgrade to the plus plan. It's not inside of the basic plan. And then you get a daily malware scanner and also firewall settings for your client websites. Then the next thing is staging. With just one click, add staging and press on continue, you will create an entire staging site of your latest backup. And this works really fast because, as you can see, within 1 minute, we have an entire staging website running on the servers of WPremote, so not on the hosting of your client, which is pretty useful. And then from here, you can visit the staging website or go to your admin dashboard. Now, this staging website will expire after 27 days, but that means you have 1 month the time to do anything you want on the website. And when you're done, you click over here on merge, and then this staging website will be put live on the actual domain. Perfect. No need for a staging plugin or difficult syncing problems. It just works. Then we scroll down and we can see all the updates for this specific website. So if you go to all, there they are. You can just select them all and press on update. And then we can choose between a safe update and a quick update. A safe update, if we press on update, what will happen is that it will actually show you how your website will look after the update. This way you are always sure that nothing will be changed on your website after updates. However, there's also an advanced monitoring, which will be coming in just a second. What this tool does, it will fetch your website. There we go, the latest info. It will upgrade the theme, upgrade the plugin. Then it will fetch the latest info again. It will compare screenshots. It will be testing JavaScript errors. And it will also be purging the cache. This way, you know for sure when you update things, nothing will break on this very important live website. Any other WordPress managing maintenance systems doesn't have this great system. So I'm really happy with this. Then over here, we have the WP activity log. You can enable this one in the plus plan. In the activity log, you will see which person changed what where on the website at what time. This way, we will never have a discussion again with our clients, but you changed it. No, you changed it. No, he changed it. We don't care. It's black and white. It's right there. And also, this will be used inside of the monthly reports. And then we scroll down. We can see over here reporting. Very important monthly reports, so your clients actually see what they pay for. All updates, everything secure, no hacks, what you did, the activity monitor on your side. All these things are very important to put inside of this report. Then we over here have performance, beta, we have the page size, total time, request client, and we actually can install Airlift just from here. So press on install Airlift. We have the free plan or the pro plan. Let's go with the free plan. Then it's going to install and run Airlift. It's a speed up plugin from WPremote itself. And I used it before and I must say I'm pretty impressed. It does the job really well. While Airlift is being installed and running its first speed optimizations, we go further over here. We have the advanced monitoring. Now, this is something really unique. Press over here on the settings. Within advanced monitoring, we have different kind of monitors. The first one is the uptime monitoring. No need for a third-party plugin, third-party service. Right within WPremote, your website will be checked every 5 minutes. Excellent. The next one is SSL monitoring. It's very important. All the times I had clients on my phone. Yes, can you check my website? It says it's not safe. You have to do something. I'm hacked. Of course, you're not hacked, but the browser says it's unsafe because of the certificate. No more with the SSL monitoring. This works really well. Also included in the monitoring is the domain monitoring. When does it need to be renewed? And where are the name servers at? And when is the last check? What are your register? All this information, which is very important. Now, and then we come to the juicy stuff, the visual monitoring. If we press on add monitor, we can do our website, like in subscribe.me. And you can choose your device, desktop, iPad, or mobile, and add in a reference image. If we click on fetch reference image, it will visit our website, take a screenshot, and put it over there. Now we have a reference image for the desktop device. Then we can scroll down here. We can check how many times this has to be checked and what is the threshold. So report me any change, any visual change, report me immediately, or tiny threshold, medium or major is okay, or gigantic 50% change, no one needs to care. So for this one, I'm gonna do 1% tiny change. If I then press save, I now have a monitor which checks my website visually every 24 hours for update and changes. Trust me when I say I have never seen this before in any maintenance plan. This is pure gold and very sophisticated, hard to build, and it works. Of course, we also need to add in a monitor for our website for the mobile device. Fetching, put it in over there, and also monitor that if things visually change, we get a message immediately. I love that. There we go. We press save, and now we have two monitors. Now the visual monitoring system works with credit. This is done so you won't add a monitor for every single page if you have 1,000 pages. Then over here we also have page content monitoring. If visual monitoring is not enough, we can also scroll down and add some page content monitoring. This is also really great because if you have really long pages, maybe a word change and it falls within the 1%, but you want to have certain keywords or phrases that are very important to have inside of your website. For instance, maybe you want to have your brand name well spent, or maybe you want to have contacts on your website, or maybe you want to have your address or your brand name, or anything you want, you can monitor it over there. You press save, and now it will be monitored every single day. Then finally, we also have a PHP error monitor. If we enable this one, it will check every 24 hours if there are any errors generated by PHP on our client side. All right, let's get back to our overview. Ooh, the performance is fixed, is now on 100 score, nice. And if we then scroll down, we can also connect our website to Google Analytics. Why do you want that? Well, of course you want to put your statistics inside of your monthly report to your clients. So they know exactly without logging in, how many people come to the website, did they convert, did they buy anything, did they contact us, did they do this, everything they can do. You can see it inside of this report. And last but not least, we have an awesome feature which is called form testing. You all know those moments when the forms didn't perform as well as you thought. And maybe for the past 3 months, then you don't get any form submission at all and you're going to test your own form and then you think, it's not working. Maybe that's the reason why I get no new clients. Now again, this makes me really enthusiastic because I have never seen this before with any other kind of maintenance software for WordPress sites. Before we go into generating reports, over here we can see all these icons again, all these things we can also do with our client websites. This dashboard is really clean but very, very powerful. Then we scroll down and we're going to create the reporting. Click over here on new report. Now you have to create a template which every single website of your clients can use. And that's really useful. First, we're going to select the template. Let's change the default template. Then we can change the primary color so you can use any kind of business color that you have. Now, don't look at this one. This is just from Firefox. If you have Chrome, you have a way more advanced color picker. Then we can change the language of our report. We have all these different kinds of languages to choose from, and more is coming, I heard. So that's awesome. Then we can change the date format. It's now a day, month, year, which is unlogical for American users. So I'm going to put it on month, day, a year. Then we can add in a start date and an end date for this report. Well, I would go with 1 month, so 25th of September, which is right today. All right, then we have different kind of pages. We have cover pages, introductions, overview, updates, backups, uptime, performance, customer conclusion, and security if we have the plus plan, firewall, and Google Analytics if we had that one enabled. Then over here, we can press on expand all. We can change the report title. And if we want to have our own logo and our own cover image, of course we want that in reporting. We have to install the white labeling, and that's only available in the plus plan. So if you have a bunch of clients, it might be interesting to go to the plus plan because you get so much more things for that. If we scroll down, we have the introduction. We can change all the text, the overview. As you can see with everyone, you can change the headline, the subheading, and the description. And HTML is also supported in there. Now, I've used different kind of tools with different kind of reports. And I must say, this is way more useful than what I had, because I had to change PHP templates to get a good report. Now, this looks way better. Now, how does such a report look like? Well, of course, the front page, all these things you can change. We've just seen that over there. We have the overview, and then we have all these things, all these modules. We have a dedicated page for that. So these are which updates you did, when did you do, what plugin, theme, or a WordPress core has been changed. When has it been done? Then we can see the backups. How many backups do you have, even with a calendar? This gives your client so much ease of mind. We also have security. How many files do you have? They had a malware scan. Okay, and something was fishy, but it's been patched. As you can see over here, when it has been patched, what has been done, hack cleanup, 38 files has been cleaned, and then one file, so something fishy was going on. We have the firewall report, bot protection, nice. Then we also have the uptime monitoring, when it was down, for how long it was down, how many percent uptime per day, really perfect. The details, there we are. Your performance score, the load time per page. And then we have the Google Analytics pages, which are very interesting and way more than just one page. You have the amount of users, the countries, the sessions by channels, users by device, everything a person wants to know from Google Analytics. And then we have some custom work. It's the last page. So if you did some custom work, you can add in, I changed this for you, I changed that for you, performed on, when did it work, because it's all inside of the care plan. And then we have the conclusion, the summary. Very nice report for your clients. Send out every single month, completely automated by WPremote. And of course, from the dashboard, you can see all the overview of all your websites. Hey, thanks for watching and sticking to the end. If you have any questions at all, just drop it down in the comments. I'll always reply. And if you want to try this basic plan for 1 year completely free, follow the link. It's also in the comments and in the description of this video. Have a great day, and hope to see you in the next video.